I joined the Live, Love, Laugh Lounge because I knew that that's what I needed to do. That's exactly, those three elements were exactly what was missing in my life. It got to a point where I felt that I was on my own. I felt like I was the only person in the world that felt the way I did. And it's just, it wasn't something that I could really explain to anybody. I was very busy and always distracting, finding other people's problems to deal with. As long as it was other people's mess, then it was okay. But what was happening to mine? I mean, what was happening to me in that, at that point? It was, I felt like, if you could ever imagine, just surrounded by sea, and there's a sense of nothingness. I was empty, very empty. I went on a retreat with Cheryl and Marion, and I tell you something, maybe part of me went to distract and help them along with their journey, but little did I know that there was more in it for me than I ever expected. We were at day 2 on this retreat, and it was all going very well. I had my nails done, my hair done, and I was feeling fantastic. I even managed to set off the alarm in the hotel. it was a lovely, lovely day. I'd had a lovely day. And then day 2 came, and I can't tell you, I don't even know what really happened in the room that day. But there was a moment where I had a question. It was a really burning question, and it's a question I've had for years, where you look at other people who are successful, they may not be as bright as you, but they're successful, and you can think, oh well, it's all right for them, isn't it? They're superwomen. They don't feel the same way that I do. They don't have the challenges that I do. And this was how I was feeling for years. And then I asked that burning question, and it was about how people were feeling. It was about how I was feeling. Did anybody else feel as alone as I did? And when I turned around, and there was about 15 women there, all with their hands up, saying, "Kerry, you're not alone." I feel the same way you do. The relief, it was like, you never know what weight you're carrying until it's been lifted. And that one single moment, one moment, the whole world just lifted off my shoulders, and I knew I was in the most amazing group that I could ever be in my life. And the shock for me was, I've been in personal development a very, very, very long time. I've coached, I've trained hundreds of people. I'm the person that people go to and say, "Ah, Kerry, you were there when I had my first breakthrough. You were here." And yet 11 years later, I was having my first breakthrough. There's no price I can put on that. There's no price at all, because I've actually, that retreat for me wasn't just getting your nails done and learning how to be better and look after yourself. It wasn't actually that. For me, it was soul food. It was food for my soul. And it was what I absolutely needed. And I didn't even know that I needed it. So I couldn't even say to somebody, "I need a retreat," because I didn't know that that was what I needed. But, life speaks for itself, and things have moved on, and I'm a lot happier in a place that actually I didn't think I could get to. You're so busy watching other people, everybody else seems happy and, living their life and, all jolly and happy. And you're thinking, why am I not feeling the same? Why has this not happened for me? But actually, it can happen. Since the retreat, I have been nominated the Wise Woman of 2017 through to 2018. So I travel all over London supporting all my fellow wise women with their awards and books and all sorts of things that they're achieving. But for me personally, I have started setting up my own business, which is going very, very well. I'm actually doing more now than I've ever done before. So rather than start and stop and start and stop, I'm doing a little bit, but often, and it's moving. And that's what I'm most pleased about. I beat off 1,500 people for one spot on the talent management course. So I am the superstar of my organisation. I'm actually the sharpest tool in the box. And it's funny because the universe puts you in places that you never expected to be, even if other people think that you don't deserve it. So it's all working. I have fallen in love with the most amazing man in the world. He is an absolute star and I love him dearly. And well, for me, I always thought women in love were stupid. I thought they do all these crazy things. I thought I'd never do that. But actually, it's happened and I'm not scared. Way! That's a real achievement. Since the retreat, I've had this book outline that I've been sitting on it since, oh, I don't know, must be a good 6 months, maybe a year, possibly. It's like that bra that you've had for 5 years and you're still hoping to sort of hang on to it. It's like that. I've had it for donkeys, but actually I've reassessed it and it's moving forward. I'm actually writing now and I'm finding the time to do the things for me. And with that, life is moving forward in a way that I'm happy. Now, I'm not going to lie to you. I have had problems in terms of friends of distance themselves from me, but that's because they realize that I'm now no longer all about them, which is what it was all about before. Now it's about me, and my time is spread more evenly. Do you know, we all have 24 hours in a day, but I'm actually spending those 24 hours far more wisely than I ever could have done, using Cheryl and Marion's tips. I've gotten rid of that monkey brain and I'm actually doing it for myself. Yay! If I could say one thing to Cheryl and Marion, it would be thank you for giving me my peace. I found peace in a way that I didn't have it before. If I could describe myself in one sentence, I would actually say I found me. And I love me, I'm okay with me, I'm happy with me. And you know what? The whole world is going to have to be happy with me because I am.